verse number given. 14th chapter of Exodus, verse number 15. Stand for the reading of the word. Let us read together. As the Lord said unto Moses, wherefore art thou unto me? Speak unto the children of Israel, that they go forth. Thank you for your vision to me. I want to thank you, Pastor Wallace, of the congregation, and Lord, go forth.
Go right now.
Following the departure from Egypt, all had gone well for the Israelites.
Yeah.
On that journey to the promised land, all had gone well. They had received from Egypt for the Egyptians jewels of silver and jewels of gold and raiment. They had found abundant pasture on their way to the promised land. Their flocks, their herds fed well. Here they were on the very verge of the desert, which separated it from the desert. Another day's journey, which bring them to the promised land.
Surely.
But prior to that, the problem that they faced, that at least they felt that it was a problem.
All right.
The Red Sea was before them.
Yes, sir.
They were afraid. Why? Why were they afraid? First of all, I submit unto you, they were afraid because they had forgotten God's past deed. They had forgotten the days of old. How God started them as a nation through Abraham. God called Abraham, I'm going to show you a land.
All right.
Watch the progression here. God says to Abraham, get out from among the children. I'm going to show you a land. And then he later says to him after he had moved forward, he said, I'm going to give you a land. God does not always unfold the totality of his plan and his purpose for you and I. Because he wants us to walk by faith. They have forgotten God's recent dealing with them. It wasn't too long before they reached this point where Moses had been brought forth on the scene by God. And Egyptians seen that Moses was a godly child, a godly looking child. Hid Moses in the Nile River.
All right.
And Moses escaped to Midian as he journeyed on. Then he returned back to Egypt to confront Pharaoh. And in that confrontation, as time went on, the Nile was turned to blood, frogs over the land, gnats, flies, dead of livestock. God was in control. Brought balls and hail, these were punishment upon the Egyptians. Locusts, darkness, even the death of the firstborn. How can they forget 10 miracles that God had performed on their behalf? They were afraid. They had forgotten about God's recent deal. And then they had forgotten that God, like you and I, they had forgotten that God was in control.
All right.
Sometimes we find ourselves full of anxiety, full of ambivalence, restless, tossed and to and fro. All because we forget that God is in control. Two things we must do. We must allow God to be sovereign. That is, he rules. He controls. And secondly, we must allow God to be mysterious. I don't need to serve a God who I can understand everything. God is mysterious. whole later said that he works in a mysterious way.
Wonders.
And his wonders are to perform.
Yeah.
He planted footsteps upon the sea and he rise in every stone. God is mysterious. Mm. I shared with the Bible class on last Wednesday, if I had to feed approximately 10,000 people, I would call Winn-Dixie, I would call McDonald's, I would call McDonald's, I would call all of these businesses to organize and give these as many sandwiches as you can or whatever.
Right.
But now God, God gets ready to feed approximately 10,000 people.
Ah.
He would stretch out and get a boy with two fishes and five loaves of bread. He's mysterious. He can do what no other power can do. They forgot that God was in control. God was the one who created and made the Red Sea, 1,350 miles long, extended it from the Indian Ocean to the Gulf of Suez. It was God who did it. They forgot that God was mysterious. They forgot that God was in control. And another thing about it, they focus on their own limitations. They focus on that limitation. What can we do? It's not about what we can do, it's about what God can do. It's about what God has already done. And if you're going to move forward in your life, move forward corporately as a church or individually, you're going to have to recognize and remember that God is unlimited in his power. God can do.
Come on.
I'm going to say something that you may know. God can do what no other power can do.
Right.
God can make a way out of Moses. God knows how to control every situation of our lives. They focus on their limitation. They focus on their limitation when they should have focused on God's provision.
All right now.
God will provide for your every need. Remember that God will provide for all of your needs, no matter what the situation is, no matter what your limitations are, God will provide for your every need. And then God is a God of protection. He will protect his own interests. We cannot devise enough protection for ourselves, but God is able. He sits high, he looks low, and God can protect us no matter what comes into our lives.
Yes, sir.
And then you got to always remember that God has a plan for
you.
God has a plan for you. It wasn't God's plan when he led them out of Egypt for them to die in the Red Sea or in the wilderness. His plan was that they enter into the promised land. Isaiah tells us that God says, I know my plans for you, and my plans are good. And everything that happens to us, we can surmise that it's all in the plan of God to do us good. And somebody says in the song, everything that happened, God did it.
Yes, God did it.
If God didn't do it, he allowed it.
Yeah, come on.
God will allow difficulties to come into our lives. Because God has a plan for us. God has a purpose for our lives. God says to Moses and the children of Israel, as well as to King David and all of us today, he said, go forward. Go forward. And I want you to understand that this is a command. It's not a request.
All right.
Will you please go forward? This command. Go forward. I know what you're facing. Go forward. I know what they have done to you, but go forward. I know what they're saying about you, but go forward. It's a command. Go forward. Don't moan and groan and complain to me. Go forward. I fought a million dollars. I've lost one. Go forward. I know the ins and the outs of circumstances of every situation. Go forward. Don't moan and groan over the pregnancy of your daughter. Go forward. I just lost my job. Go forward. Thank you, God. God who give you one job can give you another. The God who opened one door for you can open another.
Yes,
the man closed one door, God can open another. Go forward. Go forward. Go forward. Stop moaning and complaining and blaming other folks. to follow. Trust in the Lord with all of your heart. And be not the Lord. Acknowledge God in all of your ways. And God will direct you. It was a command, it wasn't a request. It was an imperative, not an option.
All right, all right.
Don't have no other choice but to go for We're going to call for the God. I'm going to change the battery and we're going to call.
Go ahead, go ahead.
I don't know exactly what God's gonna do when you are walking. obedient every quarter. But one day I'll tell you, God will never fail you. God will always be with you. God will work it out for you. God will bring you from A to Z. God will fight your battle. God will be on your side. God will give you wisdom. God will enlighten your mind. God will give you understanding. He knows exactly what to do. I don't know how you feel about it, but I came here long enough to tell you that my hope is built on nothing, that Jesus' blood and his righteousness. I cannot call the sweetest friend, but holy lead on Jesus' name. Sometimes God just fails his faith, but then I rest in here. I'm singing his praise in every high and stormy day. I make a hole within the veil of Christ. On Christ. I want to tell you what on Christ. On Christ. I sing all of the Christ. I can say, but I don't care. If I do what I say, but I'm telling you. Now go.
Somebody's still trying to live good enough to please God. You can't live good enough to please God. But Christ came down and live good enough. A sinless life to please God. And you just keep moving forward. Sometimes the devil and sometimes the devil people are going to throw your past. Your faith. But when Satan throw your past and remind you of your past, you remind him of the future. I know where I've been, but I also know where you are. I love to say, you got to stop letting folk back you up in the throne. You can't come forward. You can't serve God. You can't occupy the place that God called you to occupy. You can't exercise your gift. You cannot be bold and courageous for the Lord, because there's always somebody bringing up something. It's always somebody saying, you got the Lord to shake all of that off and keep going. Rejoicing that God will supply all of your needs. Go forward in knowing that you are God's people. You're the sheep of his pastor, go forward and knowing that there is no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh but after the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus have made you free from what the law would not do. God sending his only begotten Son in the likeness of sinful flesh and full of sin, condemned sin in the flesh, that the righteousness of the law might be fulfilled. Is up to walk not after the flesh but after the Spirit, to be conscious and minded. His death to be saved and minded. His life, because the carnal mind cannot please God. Now if he can be so that they that are in the flesh cannot please God. But I thank God that Jesus has pleased God for me. Go forward with that understanding that you are the righteousness of God. God took your sins and put them on Jesus so that you can take Jesus' righteousness and put them on you. Lift up God, but when God sees you, you don't see that fire. When God sees you, you don't see that fire. When God sees you, you don't see that fire. When God sees you, you don't see that fire. When God sees you, you don't see that hope light up. But when God sees me, you see Jesus. Why nobody who can clean my blood? Is all understanding. When God see me, he sees somebody who is on their way to the kingdom world, on their way to the blessed world. When God sees me, he sees somebody who's loving with all of their heart.
Eternal life.